So I finished braiding Jaslyn. She has a nice solid foundation for her install, and now what I like to do is make sure that I pre-thread all of my needles. One of the things that I love to do is to make sure that I have a number of needles available so that all of my needles are ready to go and that my client's time is being used efficiently and I work seamless. I pre-thread my needles. I like to use a nylon thread. I used a curved needle because for me, it helps me move faster. I go ahead and I will double knot the ends. I will cut the remaining thread at the tail so that there is no thread sticking out of their install. And I'll go ahead and put it on my workstation on a towel and work my way till I have all of my needles threaded so I can work efficiently. So when doing a curly install, there is one little secret that I like to share with you all. There's always these controversies and debates about whether you should cut your wefts or fold your wefts. And personally, I like to start my first track with cutting, and then from there on, I go ahead and I fold. So make sure that you pay attention and you follow along as I share this technique with you. Another trick that I'll share with you ladies and gentlemen is that I like to sew my perimeter braid underneath the track. This allows the client to flip their hair back and it to be seamless and for your braid not to show. So instead of sewing on the braid, I sew underneath the braid. When it comes to the end of the thread, I do go through the weft, as you can see, through the weft, secure, cut the thread, double knot it. Sometimes to make myself even more comfortable, I'll do a triple knot, and then I cut right close to the left. So there you have it. By sewing under, when we flip that hair back, you don't see no braid. And that is imperative for a seamless install.